Kevin Durant was always supposed to be reevaluated today after that left calf strain, so the Warriors not expecting him to be back, but you've got an update on whether it's official.
Yeah, I mean, he's going to officially be reevaluated before the game, but he's not close. And Rachel, I saw him yesterday coming out of the Warriors practice facility, and he was wearing some flip-flops. He was had a slight limp still. From what I understand, all he's been able to really do is upper body work and his rehab, and so he's, you know, a source described it as not close. So you can count him out for tonight. Again, not close. So
that's
I don't know
really
how close he is
to me,
to
right? Because we knew he wasn't going to play. And and after the game in Houston, Game 6, I was asking some of the Warriors senior officials. I said, "All right, if you guys go up in the series, does that extend the timeline for Kevin?" And they made it clear to me, like, "Hey, if we're winning, why would we rush him back?" Right? Which is, of course, common sense. That being said, calf strains can really vary, right?
That's
the most mild version is 7 to 10 days. It can leave you out for a month, which is a very different sort of thing. They've never really told us the severity of this injury. Have you gotten a sense if he's not close? Is it on the more severe end?
Yeah, I mean, like, there's a couple of benchmarks you have to hit, right? So you have to at least get back on the court to do something basketball related.
Right.
Okay.
Step one, you have to be able to walk without a limp.
Correct. So if all he's doing right now is, like, he takes the ropes and he's doing upper body, staying in shape. But if that's all he's doing, that means you're not even close to getting back on the court to doing basketball
Right. That to me is sort of a little red light of we got to watch this,
Malcolm Brogdon with his plantar fasciitis and they had the tear. He was still doing on the court stuff for weeks before he ever played a game.
Yeah.
Right. So it's like there is benchmarks, like Ramona said, that there's benchmarks that you have to hit and that you have to get to. So if he's not even touching any of those benchmarks, he's a lot further away than I think people think.
But here's the other thing. They played 13 players in game one. 13
That's
players in a playoff game.
Yeah.
I mean, they're getting rest for all their starters right now.
The Blazers. Are you a little insulted about that? Because Steve Kerr made it so clear that against the Rockets, he's like, "I can only trust these guys. I'm starting the Hamptons five." Yeah. And after the game, this game, he goes, "We feel this is a series we can play more of our guys."
Yeah, I mean, in the Rockets series, they played their starters averaged almost 40 minutes a game.
Yeah.
That's a lot of minutes for your starters to be averaging, but they had to lean that heavily on them.
Well,
and in the first game of this series against Portland, Klay Thompson was the high-minute guy at 37.
Right. Well, I mean, look, it's up to the Blazers. If you don't like it, make them change it. Make it different.